What's up guys, Nate Vincent here with SPRO, and we're going to be showing you how to change the oil on your 2019 Tiguan. This is going to apply for cars from 2018 to brand new, and it calls for the new oil weight from Volkswagen, which is the 020 or the 508 spec. All right, so what's unique about this new engine? It looks exactly the same as the standard 4-cylinder 2-liter turbo engines from Volkswagen, but this is a new version. This is the Gen 3. This uses a lighter viscosity oil, a 020 or a 508 spec from Volkswagen, which is available through liquid moly right here. It also uses what they call a Miller cycle. So the Miller cycle basically closes the intake valve a little bit early and allows for a more complete combustion. Makes a little less peak horsepower, a little more torque, but much more fuel efficient in general compared to the GTI or the Jetta variants of the early version of the E888 engines. Now, as far as topping up the oil, so this oil is a little bit harder to come by. It's a little bit less common these days. Volkswagen states that you can use half a liter of conventional 502 grade oil to top up the oil. Right here we have a couple versions of that. Right here the 530 spec 502, and also the Leichloff, which we run in our Volkswagen TCRs right here. This is the same thing, a Volkswagen 502 spec oil. This is an earlier specification from Volkswagen. It's used in mostly the GTIs and the more performance-based cars. You can use, like I said, half a liter, so about half of this, to top up if you have low oil. It's absolutely critical you use this new grade of oil, this 508 spec. If you use a 502 spec to top up more than half a liter, it will actually void the warranty through Volkswagen. So make sure you're buying the correct spec oil. They're always said what the spec is right on the front. You can see it says Volkswagen 508 right there. That is the new grade oil that will keep this engine in warranty and make sure that you don't void that. And now we're going to quickly go over the tools needed to do this job. So the tools required to change the oil on a 2019 Tiguan just like this is going to be a narrow headed flathead screwdriver. This is a pretty common tool. You really just want to make sure that the head is narrow enough to fit into the drain plug. If you buy the kit from us ahead of time, you can actually test fit this to make sure you can get into the drain plug before you actually jump in and start on the job. And then also to remove the oil filter housing, or sorry, the oil filter cap, you're going to need a crescent wrench, an adjustable wrench that gets up to 32 millimeter, or if you have it, you can use a 32 millimeter socket, which always makes the job a little bit easier. That's really it. This is a very simple job. This is a job that you can do at home in your garage in just a couple of minutes, and it'll save you a bunch of money in the long run. All right, so without further ado, let's jump into this project and let's show you how to get this oil changed. So the first thing we're gonna do is we need to lift the car up off the ground. And to do that, you can do a number of different things. We chose to use a lift so we can show you everything under the car very clearly. But if you have ramps, you can drive the front of the car up on the ramps. You can also use a hydraulic jack and jack stands and use these jacking points right here, these kind of reinforced metal points. You can see where it's double thick on both sides to lift the front of the car up, secure it with some jack stands, and then you can change the oil on this car. Honestly, on some of the SUVs, these cars are high enough above the ground. If you can slide a drain pan under here and get your hands up here, you can do it without even jacking the car up at all. So, next step is to drain the oil. To do this, you're going to use a relatively thin-headed flathead screwdriver. You want this head to be narrow enough to fit right inside of this little plastic plug here. And this plug is sealed up with an O-ring, so it doesn't require much torque at all. You really wanna make sure, especially when installing it, you don't over torque it. So the key is you slide in here, and we're gonna loosen this up, and we're gonna start draining the oil out of the engine. Now you can see the oil is draining relatively slow. We wanna do this with a slightly warm engine. Not hot enough to burn your hands, but warm enough to thin up the oil a little bit so it really drains out well. And if you're struggling to get the oil out, you can always take the engine oil cap off, and then you can also crack loose the oil filter, which we'll show in just a minute, and that will help draining and make it drain a little faster. So the first thing we're going to do is pop this cover off. You really want to just come under the front. It's held in with some rubber grommets. Just pop one there, pop it there, and then two in the back, one on each four corners. Let's see, right here, 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 and here. You can see this one actually came out the wrong way. So we can just pop that back in there. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to open up this oil filter housing right here. That's to get the oil filter out so we can replace it, but it's also going to allow the engine to breathe and let the oil drain out the bottom. Now, there's two ways you can do this. You can use a 32 millimeter socket, just like this, which makes it really, really easy. You can just turn it on and loosen that up just like that. But a lot of people aren't gonna have a 32 millimeter socket in their home tool set. So I wanna show here that you can actually use just a regular old crescent adjustable wrench. You get it in here, get it on there, and obviously you can turn it just like that. Now there's very low torque on this, so it shouldn't be tight. You can just loosen that up. Now, one other suggestion I'm gonna make is when you're using any wrenches or anything to loosen up this, have some rags on standby. This tends to get messy sometimes, a little bit of oil spills out. It's always good to have a rag ready so you can kind of sweep it up. And then also I like to have a trash can ready so I can take the filter out and move straight to the trash and throw it out. Take this out kind of slow. You can shake it off and it'll keep the spill contained. Now with the new rag, we're gonna just cover it up. You can see all the oil dripping off that. Now we can pull the filter out. So now to pull the filter out, what we're gonna do is simply just grab the edge there and pull it free just like that. All right, so now we have the oil filter removed. I'm gonna go install the new oil filter in the housing and tighten it down. But before we do that, what we wanna do is we're gonna pull this O-ring off and we're gonna replace it. So I'm actually going to use the same screwdriver that I loosened up the drain plug. You can use a pick as well if you have in your toolbox. Picks would work actually a little bit better, but you can use a screwdriver. The key is just to kind of really carefully get it under there. You don't want to mar up any of these threads. Use my finger a little bit. Oops, let's see. Get under there, kind of roll the O-ring onto the screwdriver, and then you can just pop it right off just like that. And get rid of that O-ring. And then included in your oil filter box right here is going to be an oil filter and also an O-ring. So now we're going to install the new O-ring. What I like to do is take my finger with some of the old oil in there and just go around the O-ring to make sure it threads in smoothly, doesn't get hung up, and you want to make sure it's not rolled over at all or else it won't seal as well. Just like that. All right. So now to install the filter, we pull the filter out of the box. Both sides are the same, so it doesn't matter if this side is down with the labeling on it or this side without the labeling, both are the same. And we basically slide that down, soft little push there. Don't push too hard, you don't want to collapse this thing, but it does kind of have a snug fit on the bottom. And then we turn this over, we thread it in, and we tighten it down to the torque defined on the top. So thread it by hand to make sure the threads engage carefully. You can see right here, it is 25 plus or minus 5 newton meters. That's very low torque. So basically tighten this down by hand. You can feel the O-ring sealing up. And now just using the adjustable to tighten this down. If you have a torque wrench, feel free to tighten that down to 25 newton meters. But I can tell you right about here, that's it. You really don't want to over tighten this. The O-ring does the sealing on this. It does not need to be that tight. All right, so here we are back under the car. Obviously, we took the oil filter out and changed it. That allowed the air to go into the oil filter housing and a little bit more oil to come down into the sump here and drain out. That's why we left the drain open that entire time. Now you can still, we have a slow, steady drip here. So we know it's pretty much fully drained out. So this is a really good time to install the drain plug. Now, the drain plug is included in the kit. It's right here. Again, this is very, very similar to the oil filter housing where it is a plastic plug. You really want to make sure you don't over tighten it. It has a little tab that will catch the oil pan right on the bottom side that will make sure it's locked in place. And it has an O-ring that actually creates the seal. That O-ring is really critical, showing you that you really don't need to tighten these down. Obviously, this is a plastic oil pan, plastic plug, so very low torque is required here. So we're going to tighten this thing. We're going to first wipe the oil off and we're going to tighten this drain up. So just a quick wipe here to make sure we're free of oil residue. Just start that thread by hand. And then I'm just gonna rotate around and you can see, if you look real closely at the bottom, you can see this little tab right at the bottom. This piece is gonna come around and it's gonna catch in it and you're gonna hear it kind of snap in place. Ready. Here it comes. And that's it right there. So as soon as you get to that, and you can see this is locked in place, that little edge is locked. You can put a little more torque on it just to make sure you're locked in place, but that's it right there. It's not going anywhere. we're ready to fill this thing back up with oil. All right, so now we're going to fill the engine up with oil. Volkswagen calls for 5.7 liters of oil in this. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put about 5.5. We're gonna start the engine, reset the engine oil change light, and then we're gonna check on the dipstick and add any oil necessary just to get it right to the top line of the dipstick. It's much easier to add oil to the oil change than it is to try to pull oil out of it if you overfill it. So right here is the oil fill. Take that off. This is a good place if you have a funnel, something of that nature, to make sure you don't make a mess on the engine. I'm pretty confident pouring oil, so I'll do it without a funnel. But yes, a funnel would make this a lot easier. Take some rags just in case and drape it around, just in case you do have a little bit of a spill. And now we're going to take our Liqui-Moly Top Tech 020. And like I said, this is the 508 spec. So this is the spec for this engine. It will not void the warranty. We're gonna fill it up with this whole 5 liter jug and a little bit of that 1 liter jug I have left on the ground. So we do suggest, if you're concerned that the engine might be using a little bit of oil, or you're going on a long road trip, something of that nature, grab an extra liter of this 520, or sorry, grab an extra liter of the 020 to stick in the back of the car in case you need to do any top-ups. You have the correct grade oil. This new 508 grade oil is a little bit trickier to find. You're not going to find it at gas stations or at big retail stores. It's a new grade. So getting it when you order oil change stuff will help you make sure you always have it in the car with you if you need it. Make sure we're locked down there. I'm going to leave these here just for a second here. Obviously, make sure you remove these before you run the engine or it gets hot. I'm just going to leave them there just because I might be topping it up after. Now let's go inside the car and let's reset the engine light. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and start the engine to make sure the engine is pumping oil and sounds right. So foot on the brake, start the engine up. So you can see we're not getting any warning lights. We're making sure that everything is running properly. Let it idle for a second. Letting it idle for a second is going to allow the oil to settle to where it goes when the engine's running, and it's going to allow us to check the oil level, and make sure it's at the right point. So now, to reset the oil change interval, we're going to turn the engine back off again. So you can see it says oil change service due. So what we do is we hold the 00 button, we tap the engine start without our foot on the brake. As soon as it brings up the reset oil light, we hit the 00 button again and it will reset the oil change. All right, so now to check the oil level, we're just gonna pop this dipstick out carefully. Pull it out and wipe it off with a clean rag. And now you can see that we're actually at the lower side of the oil. So you can see where here's the maximum and here's where we are. So we are going to add the remainder of the oil that we bought for this car. So about half a liter, that's gonna bring it up to here and the car should be good to go. So the last thing we need to do is we need to reinstall the engine cover. So we're gonna flip this over. We're gonna find our points. And then just softly press down on them to make sure they click in place. All right, everyone, I hope you enjoyed this DIY and found it helpful. If you have any questions at all, please leave them in the comments below. If you like this, please give us a thumbs up. If you want to see more content like this, please subscribe to our channel. We'll catch you on the next one.